Okay, we all do nice little turnovers for to get into a Juji Gatame. Okay. And the worst thing is you do all this nice little turnover, advanced turnover, and their last resort is to hold onto their arm. Okay? So the thing is his arm just come up. Okay, he goes down. Okay, you might come over okay, down the knee, elbows. Okay, you might do a nice little flick. Okay, then the last thing, it just says I gotta reach through and grab his do the Juji Gatame. And in the competition, you know the referee's standing there. And we all know from Saturday, how long do you get to have a go at the arm?
Five.
Not long. The moment you have a go, and then you stop, mate.
When you stop, when you pause, they say mate, so you can't pause, you've got to learn that.
Keep working. You've got to have progress, and progress is an important thing. You know, you've got to show the referee that you're doing something, okay? So the thing is sometimes you might have a go, if the arm's here, the arm will, you know, it's about to rip it off. Okay, you've got the arm lock on. Sometimes I'd say you've got to work on different things, okay? If the referee is standing there, he's actually seeing you trying to do something, whether it be with your different grip or your move, you know, you actually want to get into wasakomi first, okay, to actually create the arm lock later. Okay, if you're getting progress, the referee, something's happening here, okay? I mean, I've refereed up to a national level too, and I used to look for that sort of thing, you know? But from here, if you can, your leg that's above the hip, okay, pushes through that side, okay? And normally, you know, you can sort of fake breaking it, but you're creating just a gap just to get the foot through, okay? Once you're here, okay, so my leg over the neck area, the head area has come through, okay? Sometimes you do rollovers, you're already there. You're actually already there, okay? So the thing is, if you do happen to fall in there and he's actually grabbed over top of there, you're like, oh, well, I don't have to push it through, it's already there. So you have a look at that, okay? Now I need to trap this arm, okay? So as normal, like Sankaku, we go there, but we don't do this. Why? Yeah, pins my leg down, just trap my leg, okay? So we take the leg off, okay? It's quite amazing how many teachers still got it. Right, so come off, and trap, okay? Now, I want his hips up, right? Eh? To get his hips up, I just hook my fingers in there, and I lean down towards his face, okay? So what I do is I take my leg off, and I stick it under his bum, okay? There's a big gap there. Now I want it under his shoulders, so I roll back this way, all right? Shoulders pop up. Hello, where are we? Okay. Like I say, you don't want to sit on the ground or just arm. All right, it's all over. Okay, one more time. We're in a Juji Gatame, okay, so you can just maybe start the exercise from here. Okay, there, push through. Okay, move the leg. Check. Okay, put things in. Lean this way, I want his hips up. Through, and up. And always remember, your bottom leg acts like a pillow. Okay, makura. Okay, on his neck. Some people when they do sankaku, they're practicing, they put it halfway under their back and they go, it's not on.
Yeah, it never works.
You're trying to crush his main part of his body. Okay, you want to slip it so that you feel his body go poof onto the ground. And all of it is his head sitting on the inside of your leg. Okay, there.